Hi, Scott. First of all, thanks for being here and very excited to talk about all things related to golf and Gen AI. So with that, let me start with, I'm sure most of our viewers have heard of PGA Tour, so you don't need to do one-on-one on that, but can you tell us a little more about your organization and your role at the company?
Sure, sure. Well, it's great to be here. Thank you for taking this time to talk with me, Swami. I really appreciate it. So PGA Tour is a very exciting organization. We are responsible for the week-in and week-out golf events that happen all around the world. So it's just on the PGA Tour alone, we have about 35 events that we do. We also run four other tours here as well. So many weeks we have five, six events going on all around the world. And so it's a very busy time for us here in the middle of the summer with our events going on. I oversee all of the PGA Tour's digital platforms, as well as all the tour's broadcast technologies. I've been here at the PGA Tour now for almost 19 years. It'll be 19 years in September. So, and I've had the pleasure and the opportunity and the privilege to be able to take the tour all the way from just a website in 2005 now to generative AI. So it's been an exciting 19 years.
That's awesome. Talking about your journey, now let's talk about PGA Tour's journey. You have always been innovating with AI and ML. So maybe can you share a little bit, like what did the Tour's journey look like with AI and ML and now with Gen AI?
Sure, sure. So we've been using AI and ML for many, many years, probably for at least the past 10 years. It's played a role in a lot of our content creation and a lot of the ways that we address scoring around the organization. So our scoring, our shot length system, which is used to capture all of the ball flight and the scores for all the players across the PGA Tour at every event, has been using machine learning for almost its entire history. And so that is kind of really where it started for us. And then as we got into, you know, the last 7-8 years, as we got into using machine learning on the content side of the business, we use machine learning tools to clip all of our highlights. And in doing so, we were able to actually triple the number of highlights that we used coming through a tool set by WSC Sports. We have also been using tools to help us generate stories for our players throughout the day after an event is, after a play is done. We have, typical PGA Tour event has anywhere from 80 to 154 players, depending on the event. And generating a story or content for every one of those players is not something we can do with staff. So it's something that we've been using machine learning to do after the play is done, so that whether it's generating statistics for our players or generating the stories directly. And then, you know, we've become very excited about generative AI over the last 24 months as we've seen the platforms emerge and really begin to see how we can use generative AI to create all kinds of new experiences for our fans and efficiencies for our staff. To create compelling experiences, because ultimately our goal here is to serve our players, to serve our events, and to bring our fans closer to our players and the historic courses that we play on and week in and week out. And we believe generative AI is going to be the next step in doing that.
That's awesome. Maybe can you share some of the challenges you are trying to solve for with Gen AI, and what are some of the examples or solutions that you were actually launched so far?
Sure. So for us with generative AI, a lot of it has to do right now with how do we create personalized experiences for our fans? Mm-hmm. Again, with a large field, you know, people want to follow their favorite player, whether that's Rory McIlroy or Tony Finau, and they want to be able to be kept up to date on those players. So right now, what we're working on is a series of tools that will actually generate commentary for your favorite players across a number of our platforms. So something that we expect to have out later this year. It'll essentially create narratives around, you know, Rory's entire round as he's playing and give context to it. Right now, we've used machine learning to generate, you know, play by play. So Rory hits a drive or a shot into the green at the Tour Championship in Atlanta at East Lake, and he gets within 10 feet of the hole. Well, we can generate kind of the stayed, you know, shot one 125 yards to the green. 10 feet left to the hole, but that's all it would traditionally that you would see. Now, what we're trying to do with generative AI is create context around those shots. So when Rory gets in that position, he's 10 feet from the hole. we want to be able to do a number of things. One is tell you, how often does he make a 10-foot putt? Mm. Does he make 20% of the time, right? How often has he made a 10-foot putt on this hole in the past when he's played this event a number of times? And then bring that shot to you, whether he's made it in the past or not. So we're looking at multimodal responses, not only to give you textual information, but to show you exactly what he's done in the past. And eventually what we'll be doing is predicting through machine learning and through generative AI, predicting how important this 10-foot shot is. If he makes this 10-foot shot, is he going to win the FedEx Cup? Or is he going to take the lead in the tournament in round two? Or what position he's going to do? So I'm really begin to take that data and present it in different voices. Some of the things that we've worked with the Generative AI Innovation Center on is how do we project different tones? So if you want to hear it in the tone of a commentator or an analyst, if you want to hear it from the point of view of, you're maybe you're a 12 or 13 year old fan, you want to hear it in the point of view from somebody who's new to golf.
Yeah.
How do you explain it in that case? So we see it as a way to address a number of things, including growing our audience.
That's incredible, actually. I always found that the application of generative AI in areas like sports makes the technology even more relatable and accessible. So it's really fascinating what you're innovating with. Now, I want to double click one level deeper and say, maybe can you share a little bit details on the solution you built using AWS so that others can understand how to recreate such magical experience?
Sure. So for us, it really started working with the Generative AI Innovation Center and that team and really understanding Bedrock. Like, we were one of the earliest partners into Bedrock. So we were learning how to use it. And then what does it mean? Really, it became obvious for us for a couple of reasons. One is we had to get our data. You hear us say data all the time, but I like to say data and content together. Hmm. Because often people don't think of content as data. And that's really what the power of generative AI is how do you prepare your data, our shot link data over 20 years? And then how do you take content that we've created, whether that's our media guides, 30 plus years of media guides that we have in PDFs, or all the content that we have on PGATOUR.com, over our media asset management system, many hours of content stored in it, or video content stored in it. So those are the things that we have available to us. So how do you get that content ready? How do you index it? What AWS tools are we going to use, like Kendra, to index all of that content and have it prepared so that you can then begin to make queries against it and use the generative AI tools? And then begin to look at these tools from the perspective of what models are best for us. How do we do model evaluation? What models might work best for a query that is based on statistical information and media guides versus one that might be better at getting at the video and creating? So how can we use Bedrock, and what Bedrock tools do we use to do that model evaluation? And then once we get through that, the question became, all right, how do you build for correctness and accuracy? Correctness and accuracy in sports is paramount. We have to be right about the percentage of putts that Rory McIlroy takes from 10 feet to get the ball into the hole. So how do we build in tools and practices for generative AI to make sure that we have the correctness and accuracy? And then if we're going to build things like chatbots or virtual assistants, got to put guardrails in place, right? So how do we put guardrails in place and red teaming in place and brand alignment in place as well too? Because not only do we need to make sure that we red team for the obvious challenges of toxicity and bias, but how do we make sure that the things that are being generated are within the brand of the PGA Tour and representative of our players? And then how do we put it together in an entertaining experience, right? How do we take all of that and then put it into existing tools like our TourCast product, which is our 3D digital twin, and then suddenly be able to provide commentary that is personalized to the player that person's following? And eventually, how do we get that into multiple languages or multiple types of tone so people can actually customize it the way they want to? So each one of these steps that we're taking were exploratory steps. And then working with the Generative AI Innovation Center and the AWS teams, how do we operationalize this, yeah, right? How do we continue to make sure that what's being generated is accurate and correct? How do we continuously test for that,
yeah,
and make sure that the accuracy is always at the level that we want it to be at? And so all of these steps are the steps that we're now in the middle of putting in place I've been getting ready to roll out a series like the generated commentary will come at the end of the year. We will build, we are in the act of building the first generation of what I will be, what I believe will be great tools for our broadcast and production teams. So an example of that is I want to be able to give our announcers on ESPN, ESPN Plus, on PGA Tour Live, and our broadcast partners at CBS and NBC and Golf Channel, if they want, you know, five new talking points after every shot is hit, I want them to be able to go in and say, look, we're going to follow these five players today. And after every shot, generate two or three talking points for me so that I can then work those into my commentary to the broader audience, right?
Yeah.
And so those will help us surface things that we've never been able to surface before in a tone or in a way that I think will provide greater depth of coverage for our events.
So you talked about, you already started alluded to where you are hoping to go beyond what is possible today with Gen AI, like never before uncovered game insights. So maybe it's a good jumping off point to say, what else are you hoping to do next in with these things in terms of, is it like more game insights or different? Can you share a little bit more?
Sure. So a couple of other things, like a lot of what I talked about addresses what our fans are doing. Next, one of the things that we are hoping to address is helping our players understand their game and how they're playing, right? So creating a player agent, that is a player like Rory comes off the course, and we can have that player agent analyze his performance on that round that day and say, you know what, based on what you've told us about the way that you play your game and how you want to play on this course, here's what we've seen in your tendencies today, and here's how your statistics really played out over that round based on what your plan was. And so being able to give the players, their coaches, that ability to say, okay, yeah, that makes sense. This is the thing that you look at. Our players are they use our apps and our websites to see how they perform that day. I want to take that a step further and provide that analysis. So that would be one way of helping our players. Another way is just to help create efficiencies for our staff. You know, throughout the history that we deal with in golf is a long and storied history. The PGA Tour has, you know, been around now since 1968, and we have a huge depth of information about how players have performed, how courses have been a big part of that. And so what we want to be able to do is we want to be able to enable our staff to get into that information that is stored across shot length data, that is stored across, you know, that is stored across our media guides, that is stored across our agronomy notes, and a number of other areas. And so allow our staff to go in there when they're writing stories to say, oh, you know, tell me about how Rory performed at East Lake, you know, in his first event there 10 years ago. And then let's compare that to how Rory has performed at East Lake in 2024. And tell me what you see his tendencies are and his differences are. So providing, you know, context that our staff may have, because you know, you hire a new staff, they don't have that historical context.
Yeah.
And all, like, you know, they've had to dig into media guides or ask longer tenured staff or, you know, things like that. So these tools should be able to help with that and help us drive deeper, create a deeper set of content for our fans.
That's fascinating. Fascinating. One final question. As a technologist, I mean, who has really embraced not just AI, ML, historically, but also innovating with Gen AI. What is your advice for others who are looking to get started with Gen AI?
Sure. I think what I've learned is experimentation and education are really at the forefront of what you need to do right now.
Yeah.
Generative AI needs to be handled a little differently in every organization. And the tools are evolving so quickly that you really need to be in a place where you're not only sitting and learning, you know, from team members like the, you know, the Generative AI Innovation Lab at AWS and AWS Professional Services, who we work with closely. But you really need to be getting hands-on experience with the tools because you need to train models, you need to train guardrails. You need to teach these models what it means to work within the context of the data and content in your business. And that takes some time, but I think it's going to prove very valuable for everybody. So for us, it's definitely been, you know, experimentation and education.
That's awesome. Great piece of advice. Something that I tend to say that internally a lot as well. So really appreciate you sharing that. Scott, thanks again for actually sharing a great set of insights and your journey with Generative AI on PGA Tour. Really enjoyed our chat.
Great. Thank you so much, Swami. Appreciate it.